Lisa here again, and today we have Jessie's bedroom reveal. Jessie's 13, so just getting into the teenage years, and she wanted a bright coloured room, and that's what she got. So we'll go through all her things and I'll take you through her room. I'm just going to close the door because all the rubbish I've basically just dumped outside the door. Okay, so I'll give you a bit of a scan of her room. So she's got a wall of shelves on this wall. So basically the two kids' rooms are a mirror image of each other. So they both have the shelves on this side, the bed against the window, and then their desk against this wall. So Jessie's, all her bookcases along this wall. She will eventually get a TV which will go in that space there. She'll probably get that either for her birthday or Christmas. So again, with Jessie's stuff, there's a lot of DIY things in her room. So if it's something that I've DIY'd and I've done a video, I will link that video in the description box below if you want to see how that was done. And also, if you check on my channel, the playlist called Girls Room Decor, that should pretty much have all the videos in the one spot anyway. So starting off here, that's the first DIY that I did for Jessie's room. It's a watercolor rainbow canvas art with some gemstones stuck on in the shape of a horse head. And so looking from her shelves, she's got a couple of Build-A-Bears up the top there, a Barbie doll. You'll find lots of horsey things in her room. She's horse crazy. Couple of her trophies there. She's got all her horsey books and magazines. More horses. We've got a couple of spare shelves for Jessie as well for when she starts doing her Lego, so she can display her Lego. And then she's got a few more books down there as well as her shell collection. So like I said, on this top one here will be where her TV will go. She's got a couple of porcelain dolls there that my mum had given her before she died. There's a little jewellery stand here which I'm going to repaint and make it a little bit brighter for her room. She's got a few little knickknacks down here. Again, those three items across the front, the shoe, the hat and the handbag, they were from my mum. There's a few display pieces here that she's actually made for school, and a little skull bead art. This little guy is probably going to get a bit of a DIY makeover to make him a bit brighter, or might even turn it into a her. She has her Glee and Heartland DVD collection, which she loves. More horse models. And then down there she's got the Apple speaker box so she can play music with her iPhone. This little section's got some nail polish and nail files. She's not really into any of this sort of stuff at this stage, but I had gotten it for her, like a little beauty pack one time for Christmas, so maybe as she gets older she might get into it. She's very much horse crazy at the moment, so makeup and nail polish don't really seem to mix with that too well. Then she's got a little gumball machine. She's actually also asked me if I can do a bit of a makeover on that to make it look a bit more bright and glittery, I think. So I'll probably be doing a DIY on that one shortly. Up the top of the big bookcase on this side, we've got a couple more Build-A-Bears. Then here she's got a little porcelain teddy bear that her principal from primary school had given her for Christmas that she treasures very much. She's got her Sims disc collection there. I think there's a few more still not unpacked as yet, so we'll have to put the rest of them there. A few stuffed toys here. Then that's the start of some of her horsey Lego sets. She's got quite a few more that she's going to be doing up over time. Some more novels and fiction books. A little catch-all basket. And she's got a couple of those little baskets that we had in the girls' room decor haul. They were from Kmart and they just hold little bits and pieces. So this one is all little stuff for her horse models. She makes like little horse rugs and things for them. That's like mobile phone covers, and I think that one's just some watches and things like that. And then the bottom shelf is empty again, for expanding on her Lego collection. So back on this side, her bedside table lamp, that is also a DIY that I made over for her. And she's just got on her nightstand an iPhone charger, a little crystal jar with some hair ties in, and this is also a little potpourri thing that my mum had given her. And she's got a couple of little baskets down the side here. Also, this shelf is another DIY that I did. That was just a very cheap laminate bookcase that I repainted and also covered the insides with some colourful paper. You can see there, different colours on each one. So in the top basket, it's just a little catch-all basket. She's just got headphones and things like that in. The middle basket will have her pyjamas, and the bottom basket is the leftover stuff from her Monster High collection that she's not currently using. And that's her guitar stand there. The bed we've had for a long, long time, since Jessie was about 2, I think, and that was from Freedom Furniture, and it's a double bed. And we've just got some, that was the bright quilt covers that we bought from eBay, and a throw blanket on there, and another little Build-A-Bear Hello Kitty. Then we've got on this wall, we've got the Kmart heart wall decoration, as well as a massive collection of Monster High gear. This shelf I also made over. I don't actually have a video on it, but I just basically painted it black and then covered the shelves with a skinny piece of plyboard and covered that with contact and just put a couple of Monster High stickers that I cut out on there. So I just sort of thought it would match the Monster High theme. She doesn't really play with these dolls as such anymore, but they're more of a collector's thing for her. So if she sees one that she likes, she'll collect it. This is her desk. So she's got a couple more Monster High on her desk. Those little jars I made for her as well, that I haven't actually done a DIY on them. It's basically just a glass jar that I stuck some pearls and gems on. It was nothing too difficult. That crystal skull her Orme gave her, and normally it has some bright coloured gems sitting in the eyeballs. This is her desk. This was a furniture makeover that I had done for her. And that you will also find a link to that in the description box on this video. And inside her drawers, we haven't really organized anything yet, just sort of put some baskets in, because I'm not sure what she'll want in here when she starts school. She'll probably have a lot more school stuff in here. It's just a laptop. One of the crystal knobs broke during the move here, so I've just got to get a replacement. They were just cheap knobs I bought from eBay, so it's not such a big deal. So yeah, these all are basically empty. There's not much on these at the moment. That one's empty. And I think in here, that's just all her notebooks and a few more horse rings. And that one's empty as well. So here is her, next to her desk is her mirror. This was another DIY that I had made for her. And again, the link will be in the description box. It was just a plain brown mirror that I've just painted in a purple, covered it with some rhinestones and put some, what do you call that stuff? Gauze or netting type material. Mermaid colours all around. So for her wardrobes here, again, same as Jamie's, this single side will be where her school uniform goes. So we've got her school camping bag up there, so when she goes on overnight camps or something in school, she takes that bag. The boxes at the back there are like school memorabilia and baby memorabilia. I'm actually going to do a video on those. I'm going to sort through those and change it up a little bit, so I'll probably do a video on those as well. So yeah, we haven't got her uniforms as yet. That'll probably be next week we go to get them. Then down here, She has two tubs, one that's got all her bags in it, like her beach bags and everyday bags, and then the bottom one there is her Lego. And that wooden box over there, she likes to collect a lot of antique type things, so that wooden box was bought from an antique shop, and inside it is lots of antique type things like rabbit traps, old vintage rabbit traps and things like that. Then in the double side doors, she has up the top there, she has they were by Mattel, and they were big, like a 40 centimeter or 45 centimeter Barbie doll, and she collected all four of those, so we've still got those that we'll just store up there. That's the other quilt cover set that we haven't used, and that there was the throw, that colourful throw that goes over the quilt cover, but we didn't use that today. There's still a couple more items up there that need to be hung up, but like with Jamie's room, we weren't 100% sure where we want them yet, and that black one also, I'm going to be repainting it before I hang it up anyway. Just paint it a nice bright colour rather than black, because her room previous to this was black and hot pink, so yeah, there's a couple items up there that we still need to hang up. And in her wardrobe here, she's got her coats and shirts on one side, and then her t-shirts and little dresses and rompers on that side. And same as Jamie, she's got a cubed cabinet here that we purchased from Bunnings for about $30. Then in this one here, she's got skirts and shorts, leggings, jeans, riding pants in that one, and then underwear, socks, bras, and belts, I think, was in that last one, and then a couple of her hats along the back there. And that little one, there's a keyboard and a ukulele in there as well. So we go over to this side, and this is now the door to go into her room, and this is her school lockers here now. This also, this locker was a DIY again I did. They used to be black before, and I repainted them and decorated them. So inside her lockers here, I think she's got the top one. It's all like her art and craft kits and little things like that. This one, she said this one's going to be for her school bag and things like that. So the few things in there are what's going to be on her school bag or in her school bag. Bottom one here has just got like a little journal kit in there, like some stickers and notebooks and things like that. And I think the last one's empty as well, so they've still got plenty of storage that they can utilize. And then this little garbage bin here is also another one of my DIYs that I'll leave a link to the video in the description box as well. And that one's just like you can either use it as a storage bin or a garbage bin. And that's it. So that's all Jessie's room. A little bit of an overview for you. I've got her, focus on that, it's probably too bright. I have put the fruit bowl / chandelier type shade up there, but I will still be doing a DIY on that because I want to make it into like more like a little chandelier, so I'll be hanging some crystals and things like that off that. But we've just put it up for now so that it's not lying around, and eventually I'll be doing a DIY on that as well. Now also for her wall across there, we'll be doing a gallery wall, so a few different items and pictures and things will go up on that wall. But again, I haven't done them as yet, so they'll be future projects and future videos that will be up. And yeah, so there'll be quite a few more videos, DIY videos for Jessie's room decor items. This is it for now. So we've at least got both the kids' rooms done and they're unpacked and settled in. So I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel because I've just got pretty much the rest of the house to do. So these are just the first two rooms that we have finished already. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next video.